Welcome back. You're watching Prime Property. I'm Nayantara Rai. Earlier this week, the government came out with the FDI guidelines permitting 100% FDI in e-commerce companies, but with safeguards. 100% FDI in e-commerce companies may open the floodgates, and the ripple effect of that could be felt across real estate segments, be it offices, warehousing, malls, and even the housing market, once we see an increase in the disposable income of all of those associated with e-commerce. I tried to find out more from JLL, an international property consultant.
So there's going to be positive impact on both the accounts. If you look at on the e-commerce side and on the traditional retail side, if you look at on the e-commerce side, you know, what the new notification says that the e-commerce retailers cannot discount the prices, which really means, Nayantara, that you're going to see a lot more e-commerce players coming into India and playing a level playing field. If there is going to be more e-commerce players come in, there's going to be more office space. But correspondingly, there's going to be a huge amount of warehousing space that is going to be taken up. On the other hand, because there is going to be no price competitive advantage on the e-commerce, the brick and mortar retailers, you know, some of the categories like the electronics, like books, music, shoes, had started to suffer severely because of a huge discounted price on the e-commerce. Given that they have to play a level playing field and they can't now discount the prices, you're going to see the thrust in these categories come up, which means that the space in malls for these categories would go up and leasing activity would increase. So on both the accounts, on the e-commerce side, there's going to be growth, and on the traditional retail.
So from what you're saying, malls will do well, mall rentals may go up. Anuj, I've got to say, I thought the opposite would happen if e-commerce companies were to grow in leaps and bounds.
Yes, absolutely. So, you know, unfortunately, the rents haven't come down. And the reason for that is the supply of good quality retail real estate space hasn't increased. So because the supply hasn't increased, the prices haven't come down. Had the supply continued to increase the way we were looking at 2007 and 8, a mall a week being delivered, now we're really looking at two or three malls in a year being delivered. So the supply has got, you know, very constrained. I think with this announcement, the developers are going to be more encouraged to be able to do more organized retail real estate, and you're going to see perhaps more new building of malls that will happen.
And using the same logic, obviously offices will do well, office rentals will appreciate.
So, you know, I dare say that the office rentals will go up only because of the e-commerce companies, Nayantara. The office rentals have been going up between 1 to 3% every quarter. And that, again, has been because of demand that's coming in from the U.S. corporates who are outsourcing more and more work to India, from e-commerce companies, from domestic Indian corporates, the pharmaceutical sector, the media sector, the investment banking sector. And likewise, we're seeing a huge growth on the office side come in from the sort of BPO operators. On the other hand, we have not seen the kind of supply that is required on the office, as a result of which the office rents have continued to go up. Clearly, with more e-commerce companies coming in, the demand continues to go up more, and hence you're going to see more demand, lesser supply, rentals going up.
So when you say offices will do well, office rentals will go up, is that only going to happen in, let's say, Bengaluru, which is our version of San Francisco? You had Uber's Travis Kalanick earlier this week say Bengaluru and Beijing would rival San Francisco as innovation hubs, as technology hubs. Or do you think other cities also stand to benefit? But, you know, other big office markets, for example, Gurgaon, don't really have many startups and e-commerce companies.
That's a very good point that you mentioned. It is true. We're seeing a lot of activity in the Bangalore office market. Even on the e-commerce front, we're seeing a lot of more activity in the Bangalore market. And that's largely because there's a huge amount of talent available. And the new e-commerce companies, which are startups, or the American e-commerce companies who are looking to set up base in India, for all of them, the preferred destination remains as Bangalore. And you will see disproportionate absorption or disproportionate demand getting into Bangalore than some of the other cities.
What about warehousing? Is that a new investment opportunity?
So, you know, warehousing traditionally in India has been a neglected sector. If you look at our warehouses, you know, you've got pilferage happening, you've got mice, and you've got lots of rodents in there, and you know, there's a huge amount of loss that happens on the warehousing. The new quality warehousing, which is what the e-commerce companies are looking, which is the where the more sophisticated FMCG companies are looking, is really the rentals have gone up on those warehouses, and the demand has increased. You know, recently we heard Warburg Pincus coming into the warehousing sector, and they have continued to invest in that sector. You know, Everstone is very big on the warehousing sector, and likewise, you're going to see more companies come into the warehousing and logistics sector. With e-commerce play and more depth in e-commerce and more companies coming in e-commerce, they do need delivery centers. And whether those delivery centers are large warehouses or more city center warehouses, they would need a place where they're able to store the goods before they're really shipped out. So clearly I see a lot of demand on the warehousing side because of the growth in the e-commerce.
And how are people like you and me, the retail investors that we call in the stock markets, how are they supposed to approach the warehousing space and look at investments? What kind of growth projections do you have? Do you see rentals going up?
In terms of the growth, I can tell you is that the warehousing will continue to see a lot more growth in the rentals than even the retail. And that's because the shortage of good quality on warehousing is far greater. And if I was to hedge a number on the warehousing, it'll be anywhere between sort of 8 to 14% every year that you're going to see on the warehousing as the quality continues to improve, productivity in those warehouses for the occupiers continue to improve. And on the malls, I would say is it'll be between sort of 7 to 9% growth every year.
So a lot of positives there for the real estate market, new opportunities for investments. And of course, the housing market should get a boost once we see a rise in the disposable income of all of those associated with e-commerce firms. With that, time for a short commercial break. On the other side, we'll tell you about one of the largest deals in commercial real estate that is brewing. It's happening in Mumbai. Stay tuned for that.